Welcome back to YouTube online classes for BSc first semester. So subject is geology. In the last period we have already discussed about the general characteristics of plate lamellitis and classification of plate lamellitis. So today we have to discuss the continuation part of the plate lamellitis. That is parasitic adaptation of plantae lamellitis. Parasitic adaptation of plantae lamellitis. So first we have to discuss about what is the meaning of parasitic adaptation. So parasitic adaptation is nothing but the animal which is live in another body of the animal, that is the host animal, which the plantae lamellitis or plant worms which is live in another animal, that is the host animal, and it will get every metabolic activities inside the body of other animal, that is called as parasitic adaptation. So this parasitic adaptation is depending on mainly two processes or two characters. So one is morphological adaptation. And second one is physiological adaptation. So parasitic adaptation in a plantae lamellitis is mainly have two processes. The one is a morphological adaptation and another one is physiological adaptation. So morphological adaptation is nothing but there is a structure of the animal, structure of the plant worm. So that we have to include in morphological adaptation. And another one is physiological adaptation is nothing but how they have to get the food, how they have to respire and how they have to start their fertilization. That is a physiological adaptation. So first we should understand that morphological adaptation. So this morphological adaptation is having some of the characters. So one is body covering. And second one is the organ of adhesion. And third is organ of locomotion. And organ of nutrition. And neurosensory system. And the last one, that is reproductive system. So these are the morphological adaptation in plantae lamellitis. That is the parasitic adaptation in morphological adaptation. Morphological is nothing but there is a body. How the body structure are depending on a host plant. That is the characters of morphological adaptation. So first is body covering. Body covering is nothing but there is a flat worms. Flat worms are having body covering. There is a thin mucous membrane is there. This membrane we have to say that the body covering. So this body covering is also called as tegument. This body cover is also say that tegument. So this is very very important in morphological adaptation in another host animal. Means these parasitic animals are living in another body of the animal. So that's why these are first they have to adjust with the body covering. Body covering is nothing but they have to hear one animal, whatever it may be. So this tapeworm, I took the example is tapeworm. So this tapeworm is live in another animal intestine. So this is intestine we have to consider. So this tapeworm will live in this intestine of the host animal. Means first it will adjust with the morphological adaptation that in the body coming. This is mucous membrane is very very soft and it will fixable with the animal of the host. So that is the first body coming, the host animal and the another one parasite animal, both are adjust and this parasite animal will attach you to the host animal by the help of body covering, that is a tapeworm. And next one is organ of adhesion. Organ of adhesion is nothing but there is a certain special character of plant animal. This one is scolex. This scolex is having suckers and hooks and spines. So these are the adhesion character of the morphological adaptation. First, the body covering which is adapted or covering with the host animal. After that, the organ of adhesion. These are suckers and hooks and spines are attached to the host animal. And next is organ of locomotion. So here the body of the parasite will locomote in the intestine of the other animal by the help of locomotion. They have to move from one place to another place in the host animal by the help of locomotion. So these locomotions are not considered any organ, but the cilia like means spines. These spines are looking like the hair like structure which is present on the parasite of the animal. So by the help of cilia or spines, the tapeworm or the parasite animal will move from one place to another place. So that is the morphological adaptation by the locomotion. The next in organ of nutrition. Nutrition is nothing but they have to suck the food. So they have to suck the food by the help of pharynx. So here they have to get the food by the help of pharynx in the host animal. Suppose this is the host animal, this is the tapeworm or parasitic adaptation animal. So this parasite animal will get the food by the help of this host animal. So this host animal, by the help of host animal, this parasite will get the food by the help of pharynx. By the help of pharynx it will get the food. So that is the organ of nutrition. Next is neurosensory system. So now the adaptive animal will adapt it in the host animal by the body covering, after by the help of adhesion, after by the locomotion, then after they have to get the organ of nutrition. After all these, they have to adjust with the host animal by the help of neurosensory or system. There is a primitive nervous system is present in the plant elementis, but by getting food they have to adjust with the help of neurosensory system. Only the eye spot is present in these animals. Eye spot is nothing but there is a only little primitive system of nerve sensory organ is present in these animals. So after all up to here organ of nutrition they have to get adjusted with the host animal and they have to get the messages by the eye spot. So that is the neurosensory system. The last one is reproductive system. In a reproductive system, in a host animal only they have to survive. Means they have to regenerate their population. So how they have to regenerate? By the help of reproductive system. So these reproductive system is hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite is nothing but two types of individuals are formed by the help of the animal. So by the help of reproductive system in the tapeworm or in the plant elements in the host animal, they have to divide it and rapid division is formed by the help of the gut and pharynx. Means these are very very helpful to produce more number of host animal. So this is the morphological adaptation. They have to get the food, they have to adjust in the animal, and they have to restart their generation in the by the help of morphological adaptation. Then next one is physiological adaptation. Physiological adaptation is nothing but this is only the structural adaptation. So physiological adaptation is also having some of the characters. One is protective mechanism. And second one, anaerobic respiration. Then next, osmoregulation. And last one is high fertility. So these are the some physiological adaptation of parasitic adaptation in platyhelminths. So first one is protective mechanism. Here the protective mechanism is body covering. So in a by the help of protective mechanism, so here first the body of the host animal will get the tapeworm inside the body, then it will protect mechanism. Protect means it will form mucous membrane around the animal. So mucous membrane of the animal is formed by the mucus. Mucus is nothing but mucous membrane is formed around the parasitic animal by the help of mesenchymal cells. The animal will form the mucous membrane or tegument is formed around the body. That is the one mechanism. The next one is anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration is nothing but the animal will not get the pure oxygen by the host animal. So, depending upon their gut and other glucose particles, this tapeworm or any other platyhelminthes will get the food by the help of breakdown of glucose into parts. And in the part of gut, it will respire by anaerobic respiration. So that is called as the formation of breakdown of glucose, and it will get the food, get the respiration by anaerobic process. The next one is osmoregulation. Osmoregulation is nothing but osmotic pressure. It will form in the body. Means here the host animal will also respire, as well as the adaptive animal is also respire in a host animal. So depending upon that, there is a high respiration is formed in the body of host animal. Depending upon that, it will increase their osmotic pressure in the body. By the help of osmotic pressure in anaerobic respiration, it will form a high fertility of eggs. High fertility of eggs, nothing but it will produce millions of eggs in the anther period of their one adaptation. So millions of the eggs are formed by the help of anaerobic respiration and osmoregulation process. So this is the physiological mechanism. Both are related because morphological formation is formed in the body of tapeworm or in the parasitic adaptation. Later they have to adjust in the host plant by the help of physiological adaptation. So this is the parasitic adaptation in platyhelminthes. In the examination, if you ask for 5 marks, and it is a very important question in your examination. So this is about the parasitic adaptation in platyhelminthes. So in the next period we will continue.